Hey, are you looking into email marketing tools that you can use and you want to compare them, see which one is better, which one is more cost effective? Or you are already familiar with Klaviyo and with the other tools, but you are really looking into the pricing structure and you just don't get how it works? Or maybe you already use Klaviyo, but you want to get some tips, some hacks, how you could save some money and increase your ROI on this thing. If you want to see what Klaviyo wants to present to you, then go to Klaviyo's pricing page on Google, and they try to make it easy but or simple, but actually it's not that simple. They only ask for the contacts. I don't know, let's say I have this number from 5500 to 6000, and then you can choose if you want to do email and SMS or only email, or you want the free package. But in this way they can target the three main audiences: the guys who want to start and, you know, just have a trial, or those guys who want only email, or those guys who want email and SMS as well. Probably most people, I think they are okay to pay for it, but they only want email. That's you know, the segment of people that I can see the most. So let's focus on that. I pick the size of my email list. Yeah, it's definitely more expensive than MailChimp, but we know Klaviyo delivers, and you can get great results, great data, and great ideas as well. A great email editor. I think it's purely worth it. You get also push notifications, which is great, and then a free monthly SMS and MMS credit. So actually you can send some text messages as well without actually paying for that. Includes applicable SMR carrier fees, email and chat support. So this is what you get. If you want to go with the free, you can have 500 monthly email sends. So it doesn't mean that your list can be 500 people. It can be, but then you can only send one email to each. So if you want to send multiple campaigns, you need a smaller list. And you get the push notifications, some SMS as well. Actually, the free plan is pretty cool. If you want SMS, then you have to pick separately how many credits you want to have for SMS. So each credit means one text message sending. Let's say I want to send one SMS campaign per month. I have this list size, so I need 40,000 credits, and this is my end pricing. I definitely recommend using this one because SMS has even a greater ROI than email marketing. Definitely check this out. Now let's look into the hood even more. I want to show you a real account and how this really works. So if you go to billing here, create your plan, yeah, you can see everything here. So this is the current plan for my company's Klaviyo, $45 per month that we pay because we have a small list. So let's say we have this list size, and this is not even the full list size because this is only active profiles. So in a few minutes I will tell you how you can save money. You don't want to pay for everyone on your list, only for the active people. There are a few ways to, you know, work around this. But let's say we have this many active profiles, how many monthly SMS credits we need. Let's say this number. In fact, we don't send any, but let's say we need this one, and then choose a plan. Klaviyo gives you recommendations, which is pretty cool. So the first one is recommended, 1500 active profiles, this many email sending, SMS, which includes all of these. We don't have access to Klaviyo One, which is more like an enterprise level tool. It's their data analysis platform they rolled out last summer. If we want to send more text messages and more active profiles, then this is the amount more SMS credits. So basically Klaviyo wants to upsell you, really. It shows you different options. But if I put in, let's say I have 50,000 people, which is more realistic for an e-commerce store, I want to send out 50,000 text messages, then the price differences will be probably bigger. So 50,000 active profiles, half a million monthly email sending, 50,000 monthly SMS credits. Here it's 10% more, so the price is higher as well. And then here the list size is bigger, the active profile number. They try to upsell you on more active profiles for email or SMS credits. Also, you can go here and you can see the tiers, so you can see how it changes by different packages. And they have the same for SMS. Also, here you can see the current cycle usage. Usually close to the billing, to the next billing date, it will show you the highest percentage of this bar will be colored. Sometimes you will get a message that you are very close to run out of your credits or active profiles that you can have. Usually they send you an email once you get beyond 90% in the given month. Once you get this email, it's better to pay or do something else with your list. Alright, so now let me show you a few ways how you can optimize your pricing, because for every profile and every sent text message you have to pay, you know, the more you pay for inactive profiles, the more expense you will have, and the ROI, what you have on email and SMS, it will be lower. What you should do is smart segmentation. Basically, you can create segments like this one. We usually do it based on engagement. So here's an example, engaged 180. And here's the definition. Somebody opened an email 0 times in the last half a year. Same with clicks, and they were created at least 6 months ago. So we want to make sure that they had time to see our emails, but they still didn't open it. This is how the definition looks like. And the connection between each is and, not or, make sure of that. But basically this is what we use. You know, people ask, okay, but this 6 months, 180 days, is it good for my store, or I should use a lower number, higher number? I think it's good as a general practice, but the real number really depends on your business. So if your customers usually buy often, let's say you sell supplements and they have to buy it once a month because of the packaging, I would use a shorter cycle, more like 90 days, and then for these you have to change it to 90 days. But let's say you sell furniture, people buy it once a year, every second year, then I would be maybe 700 days and you can find those people. You can update the segment, but once we have those people and there are 500 people here, basically I just check a few profiles if these people are really, you know, fit the segment that I picked. And this guy subscribed a long time ago and then unsubscribed almost 3 years ago. So yes, he fits this segment. So we find these people, and after what we want to do is make them suppress profiles so we don't have to pay for them. Okay, so now once I have the people, the segment of people, basically you have two choices. One is you can go to settings and you can go to other profile maintenance. You can pick this segment and you can just delete them. That's one option, and it's easier to do, but once you delete these people, you cannot recover them. So that's one option. Alternatively, you can also download them, and I will do it now as a CSV. If you want, you can pick all the properties or only the email and start exporting. Now I won't do it. So you can, you know, save it on your computer or you know, wherever you want, and after you can go and delete. This is one option. So they will be removed from Klaviyo, but you can make them inactive profiles in a way that Klaviyo doesn't charge you. And the description of that is here. And basically the process is similar. You export this list as a CSV, and after you navigate to profiles, click the suppress people link in the upper right of that page and select upload. We can do it to go to profile, view suppress profiles, and here I can just import the CSV file that previously I exported. So here's another option. But basically in this way you can have more profiles on your Klaviyo account that you pay for. So now let's moving forward. Let's talk about the cost effectiveness of pricing and really how to define the ROI and what you should pay for. So besides this suppression thing, and really just deciding how your buying cycle looks like and how, you know, how much you want to pick and really keep those profiles who open or doesn't open your emails and they engage with your emails or they don't. You want to see the value of one subscriber. You want to see the lifetime value of one subscriber. And one of the benefits of working with us that we do these calculations for our clients. So actually we collect the data, we have have them here. You can see the number of profiles for each segment, the total lifetime value. This means the past lifetime value, how much they purchased until now, but also how much we expect them to purchase in the future. And this is based on the calculation of Klaviyo. You can go to, actually we don't have good data because this is not an e-commerce store, but Klaviyo shows you how much this person has spent until now, and also based on prediction how much they are likely to pay to buy in the future. In this segment, the engage 120, there are 9,000 people. On the average, they spend more than $100, and they are expected to spend $33 more in the future. So their total lifetime value is 166, and the number of average orders, number of future orders, what we can predict. We have all of these numbers. You can even do this calculation. So I want to see, I will do it with the all active profiles. So I want to see what's the lifetime value of the total segment. So we can multiply the number of profiles on the on this segment with the value of each subscriber, and we have this number. So the worth of this segment, all active profiles, is around almost $200 million, the total lifetime value. And that is a past value and a future value. So the future value of this segment is this one, based on prediction, $350,000. And then of course this segment will grow bigger in the future. Maybe in the future they will spend more money, your average order value will increase. So there are many factors, but still I think this calculation really helps. I will just pull this to everywhere. So these are the future values of these segments. And I think it's a very interesting calculation. So this helps you really see if Klaviyo is worth it or not. You can play around with the numbers. Let's say what happens if this segment becomes smaller. I think this will really help you to see if paying $2K for Klaviyo is helpful or not really. It's just not worth for your business. So I hope this guide was helpful for you. And remember, anytime you can register for free, and you can send out 500 monthly emails if you don't want to pay for it. So I think it's worth the time to look into it further. I'm pretty sure soon you will pay more for Klaviyo to see the ROI on this platform. Hey Budai Nation, I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you did, make sure that you go down and you subscribe to this channel. Also hit the notification bell so you get updated of my newest videos. Our purpose, our mission, is to help at least 1,000 e-commerce stores grow and scale, focusing on retention and the lifetime value of their customers, because too many of them, they just focus on acquisition and boring ads, which is quite unfortunate. And also, before I leave, let me give you the link of the blog article, and this video was based on that one. You can find it below as a link. Also, I will give you a 50-point checklist that you can download and use and really just audit your own e-commerce email marketing. That's what we use with our clients too. That being said, stay tuned, see you in my next video.